portrait mode, huh? So it's gonna be portrait mode now. Great, fine. Not my business. I'm on an off day on the Dead & Company tour and thought that I would take over Electric Lady Studios for the afternoon and take you through the making of my single, New Light. It's a single that I produced with no ID. And I thought we'd go into it and break it down track by track, sort of take you behind the song. So I got together with No ID back in the spring, and he would go through his laptop and play these chops and samples that he had. And this loop hit me that he played, and I sat up and I went, uh-oh, took the guitar. And this was the loop. And, that's it, really. And I went, ooh, that's woozy, wavy, and weird. And I picked up my guitar, and it was also open enough harmonically that I could write to it. So I wrote these four chords to it. A minor, D, G, C. So we had written this loop. Next thing we did was put some drums on it after I'd come up with that. So there's a little bit of guitar here if you want to put that in. That doesn't really define the melodic stuff yet, but No ID got up and he went to a Lindrum, which is this great old vintage drum machine. You've heard it on Prince records, Michael Jackson records, tons of records. So this is what that is. And really all it is just a kick. That's a four on the floor, so you get a kick underneath the snare as well, which makes it drive. And then you've got the classic Lin clap, you know, once a bar. It's like the Prince, you got a Prince clap, but like, that's how you do it. So open-handed Prince clap. So this is sort of what I wrote to. When I had this, I knew I had something. So I'd go back to my hotel room and I would just jam out and sing. It has this kind of thing, you know? You know, it was kind of 80s thing. So I knew I had something. And we had the vocal, I had some ideas. They're gonna see me in a new light. So once I sat there that first night, give me just one night. That's kind of all I had, stuff going like that. So then we got Aaron Sterling to play some drums on it, and that's what this is. And that's a live drummer, just the overheads, because you've got to get this drum machine to interact with live drums. And if you've got too much going on the drum, the live drum section and the program drum section, it just becomes like popcorn. So it was really cool to take just the overheads from the drums. And then we got Mr. Pino Palladino. I put some Lindrum shaker on it, so every once in a while you hear this thing, it's like that. So now you've got like the bed of the tune. I'm just jamming to it for a second, I'm not even thinking. So then I start putting some guitar on it. So there's not really any defined guitar chords in this song, which for me is such a breath of fresh air because it takes the onus off of me to make everything happen on the guitar. It's really fun when you've got everything doing a little bit of lifting to just play a little guitar on it. And second verse is kind of a good example of what the electric guitar can do with single notes, to just push something forward and make it half melodic and half rhythmic. And it's this guy. We're now on the bridge, check this out. This guitar part right here is played on Prince's guitar. And I'm not making that up. It was an incredible day because we were working on this part of the song, which was definitely Prince-tastic. And the guitar magically came across the table in the studio from a friend who, it just appeared for an hour. And we didn't know it was coming. And we were working on this part of the song that needed this part. It was one of the strangest, most beautiful, serendipitous moments. Prince's guitar showed up. So we sort of like got into the spirit of the way Prince would have done it. We plugged it into an API, put a little compressor on it. So that's actually, that part of the song is direct input. It's not even through an amp. My favorite thing to do is to take like four chord loops and cut into them and add a moment here and add a moment here, you know. So when the first day I had the song, it just went around and around and around. But there's a couple of moments where you can put events in that actually for just a one bar, make the song feel like it's not looped out. And there's this moment at the end of the solo going into the last chorus. That's cool. The other thing I want to show you is when you got a guy like Pino Palladino and you got a turnaround like that, you just set the dude free and you go, just feel it out. So here's what Pino does under that turnaround, which is just insane. This one bar makes the last chorus feel like you've never heard it before. And it's really, really cool. And then you've got the background vocals behind that. And the background vocals are interesting because when you background vocal yourself, it can be too much of the quality of your own voice, and then it just gets like, well, who's the lead singer and where's the background coming from? That's maybe three, four of me flattened out, meaning pitch-wise, like real hardcore auto-tune, because I don't use auto-tune on vocals really. But you can use auto-tune as an instrument, and the way we use it as an instrument is to turn the vocal into more of a synth part, which is where you get. So you get these. So it feels like me, but it's. If you give it just one night to meet you underneath the moonlight, what do I do without this? What do I do? Check this out. This love that's running through my veins. What do I do without this? What do I do without this love that's running through my veins for you? Whatever works, people. So there, I guess we have it, of the song New Light. It was so much fun to make. And again, I'm going to play you New Light in the order which we added stuff. So you will hear during the playing of this song how it came to life chronologically. So it goes like this. And there you have it.